Good afternoon.
Very good afternoon. Please be seated. Thank you to me. Thank you. Be seated. Okay. So comfortable? Ready for the interview? Okay. So, Ms. Jyotirmay Dalai, can you please tell us something about your name and how does it justify your personality?
Sir, as you know, my name is Jyotirmay Dalai. Sir, the word Jyotirmay means it's a light source, a source of light. So, sir, I believe that positive thoughts make a person good and positive too. So, and I try to make my friends and family members feel positive about themselves and about everything that's going on around them.
Why banking?
Sir, banking in particular, I'm personally interested in specialist officer. Because, sir...
Can you please speak up? Not audible.
Okay, sir. Sir, personally, I'm interested in specialist officer only in particular, in AFO only, yeah. Not PO. Because, sir, as I'm a agricultural graduate, so I feel my knowledge that I acquired during my graduation years and the post-graduation years will be helpful. And so, sir, that's why I opted
for... Why do you think that this bank will hire you?
Sir, because I'm qualified for it. Personally, so I completed my graduation as well as post-graduation, and sir, I'm...
Apart from this educational background of yours, do you think that you are suitable for this post? I mean, you should be hired?
Sir, I feel that I personally meet all the requirements that are generalized by the banks for a specialist officer in particular area.
Like, what are the qualities in you that you think you are suitable?
Sir, as you know, the work of an AFO is sanctioning loans. And they also deal with farmers in particular, and they also go for farm visits. So, sir, during my RAVE program that was conducted in the final semester of graduation, sir, we were exposed to the farmers in Sonpur area. Sir, there I had a very good rapport with those farmers. So, I feel that I can interact with them and also get to know...
Is there anything that you have told that the other persons before you who have attended these interviews and who are yet to attend the interviews?
Yes, sir.
So, do you think that they are lacking in these qualities? How can you distinguish yourself from others?
Sir, I believe that I am capable of it. But, sir, I don't know about them. So, I am not the right person.
Everybody says that he or she is capable of this. What is this?
Sir, this is...
Sir, what are the challenges that the farmers are facing these days?
The challenges are nothing new, because earlier also they were facing the problems regarding the credit requirement, regarding the knowledge that they possess about the farming cultivation, about the cultivation procedures. But sir, nowadays the problems are a bit complex in terms of the market. Some of them are...
I'm asking about today's problems. What are the problems they're facing these days? I'm not asking about the past challenges, present challenges.
So presently they are somewhat, it's difficult for the farmer to get updated with the new varieties. And they are also...
Can you please answer me in a bullet way? That number one point, what are the reasons? What are the number one challenge they're facing?
Sir, regarding innovation.
Innovation?
Yes, sir.
Innovation.
So innovation in the sense, sometimes in our KVK or with the scientist field, we're discovering new varieties which are sometimes not accepted by the farmers, but they are successful in our research plots also.
You're talking about multi-cropping?
No, sir, not multiple cropping. Sir, new varieties.
New varieties. New varieties.
Yes, sir. Sometimes they are not...
This is the first challenge they're facing. They are not innovative enough to go for new type of breed. Are you talking about that?
Sometimes they are just cautious about adopting new technologies, like new innovations like Happy Seeder, and sometimes the plant residue management, like in Northern India, they are burning those, so they are not directly affecting them, but they are affecting the normal people.
Okay, what are the initiatives taken by the government for the betterment of the farmers that you think?
Sir, sir, they have gone for these farm bills. And they have also been discovering new equipments like Happy Seeder and various mechanization programs. where the farmers can easily avail.
What is the most successful initiative taken by the government and accepted by the farmer, and really it has brought change in the livelihood?
Sir, recently the reforms regarding organic farming, particularly in states of Sikkim, where they have easily adopted the organic farming, because earlier also they were using the same practices, and now also they are using the same practices.
Organic farming belongs to which type of provision, which type of scheme, which type of initiative?
Sir, I'm guessing this one. No, it may be, sir, Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana.
You're not sure about that?
No, sir, I'm not sure about it.
Okay. Now, when, I mean, you are posted in an area where neither the co-workers in your bank or the villagers, they are not supportive enough. So, how are you going to adjust in that situations? And there is an option with you that you may go, you may not go. You may accept the transfer, you may not accept the transfer. So, do you think that you are, what is going to be your course of action?
Sir, I will attend.
That's it.
Yes, sir. I'll accept this, because before applying this for a job, I was personally very much prepared that I'll be working anywhere in India, and co-workers can adjust with any person over time. So I feel.
No, I'm just asking you very specifically that any reason that you have taken the decision to go there, because there is no pressure on you. You may choose, you may not choose. What is that particular thing that you have opted for this time?
Sir. It's just my duty, so I will go for it.
So, duty doesn't deny you to be here, I mean, doesn't pressurize you to accept it. You can also continue the job at present. Okay, if you're accepting this, then how are you going to adjust with them?
Sir, it will take up, I think, 1 or 2 months, then I will interact with them. I feel that I'm good enough to build a rapport with them. So, sir, I will.
Any specific plan of action that you can do? Apart from this interaction, because everybody is going to interact. What are your extracurricular activities?
Sir, I dance. Sir, I'm good at dancing, and sir, I also like to draw and do craft things.
How do you value a bank? How do you value an organization? Any organization you are choosing to work for, how do you value that?
Sorry, sir, I'm not in a position to understand this question.
Do you see any difference between extracurricular activities and hobby?
Sir, hobbies are something which I pursue during my leisure time.
What's
your hobby? Sir, I love doodling. Sir, doodling. And
what is
that? Sir, doodling is, like I'm sitting idle. So I try to draw something and fill it up with lines. Say, if I'm going to draw a circle, then I do some art inside it. It's just.
Okay, Ms. Dadai, so you told you have maintained good rapport with the farmers, right? If some farmers in a particular branch, you have worked in that branch as an agriculture officer, right? They have put pressurize on you to sanction loans and putting political pressure, then in that situation, what you will handle this situation? I belongs to this party, I belongs to that party, right? Then you sanction my loan. As a lady officer, how will you handle this situation?
First of all, I like to check their history, what kind of loans they have taken, how the loans are recovered from them, and after taking a look on that their history, thereafter I'll decide my course of action.
Okay. Suppose that in a branch, your subordinate staff is not cooperating with you, whatever you are ordering. See, he or she is not cooperating with you, then how you will take action, means how you will take proper action against him or her as an agriculture officer? Basic action, how will you approach in this matter?
Sir, I believe that as a senior, I can order him or her, and if he or she is not working according to the orders, then I may ask some of his or her friends to just tell him that do this or this thing, or else if he persists on doing the same mistakes over and over again, so I will take some actions against him or her.
Okay, who will be the higher authority in branch? Obviously, branch manager is the higher authority. So you should discuss all those things. Okay. Okay. Do you know what is a garnish order?
Sorry, sir. I don't know.
Okay. Do you know what is attachment order?
No, sir. I don't know.
The order came from court. It is known as garnish order. Right. Court. Right. District court or high court. Okay. And the order came from the income tax department. That is known as attachment order. Do you have any idea about that or not?
No, sir, I don't have any idea.
Okay, what is the banker and customer relationship in the case of deposits?
Deposits.
Some customer is coming in the banks to deposit some money and taking loan from the banks. Then what is the relationship between banker and customer?
The customer is coming and trusts the bank officials with.
The relationship is known as debtor and creditor. Do you know what is debtor? What is creditor?
Sir, a creditor is one who gives the credit. Sorry, sir.
Okay. Do you know what is the clean note policy of RBI? RBI's clean note policy.
Sorry, sir, I don't know.
Simple things.
Sir, clean note.
Clean note policy, what it will justify? You tell me. Tell me. Then the notes should be clean and clear. If some torn note or something note is came or some fake note came, soil note came, then how will you report those things and how will you keep all those things? Clean note policy, right? Okay. Okay, no problem. Okay, one more thing. You are working as a general banking officer in bank, right? Apart from the agricultural work, right? In bank, right? Four fake notes are came. Four forged notes are came, right? Then how will you treat this situation?
Fake notes are coming.
Fake notes came. One person deposited four fake notes in the bunch of the notes, right? So how will you treat this situation and the fake note, whether you will submit the note to the customer, means return to the customer, or that you will keep this note, or what will you do? Any idea?
Sir, I'm not sure about the procedure, but sir, maybe those notes can be exchanged at the commercial banks or with RBI branches.
Okay, one more thing. What is your first bank preference you have given in your preference IBPS?
Sir, Canara Bank.
Canara Bank. Okay, who is MD and CEO?
Sir.
Okay. You should aware about all those things. Okay.
Okay. Jyotirmay Dole. Okay. You are pursuing your master's in entomology. Okay. What he was asking actually, that how to some forged fake notes. Yeah, as actually in the bank, you are working in the bank, so it has come to you. Some four fake notes has come to you. So what you are telling actually, it should be exchanged. It cannot be exchanged. It's only soil notes, torn notes. Actually, mutilated, it is called soil mutilated, cut notes can be exchanged, but forged notes cannot be exchanged. So there is a provision, anyway actually you are not actually, may not be actually 100% you are going, but it cannot be exchanged. Actually, some procedure is there to report to police so many things are, other things are there, okay, but actually it cannot be exchanged, number one. Okay, you are student of entomology. Okay, entomology means what are the types of storage available in agro-based products? Types of storage. Storage facility actually after the harvest of grains. So what actually storage is required? Okay. So and as a student of entomology actually you should know how to actually store these products. What are the types of storage prevalent in for storing the agro-based commodities?
Sir, there are bulk storage system wherein bulk storage structure. Yes, sir. Okay. So bulk storage structure where many sacks of grains are stored one after other, and then there are some traditional structures like
basic things actually that it is a three types of storages are there. One is open storage, and is semi open storage, and is closed storage. That is the thing actually. So when what type of crops actually open storage is advisable, where actually closed storage is advisable, or semi open storage. Which type of crop, which type of grains are suitable for open storage? No idea? I think as a student of entomology, this thing you should know. These are very basic questions. Okay. What is the nowadays actually we are very much actually everybody is talking about this integrated pest management. What is that integrated pest management?
Integrated pest management is the practice where we include various practices of pest management in a feasible manner and in an economically viable situation. For example, it's an integration of cultural methods, mechanical methods, physical methods, and chemical method of control. And also,
whether it includes biological method also?
It also includes biological method.
Okay. What is then biological method of pest control? Whether it is advisable or not? Whether as a student of entomology, whether you should advise the farmers to go for this biological method of pest control, whether is it effective?
In my studies, I have seen that biological control is very much effective, but it can't be incorporated with our habit of using the chemicals. Because when we are using biological control, then it's advised that many shots of insecticides should not be sprayed after 7 to 10 days of spraying using the biological control agents. For example, if we are using Isotema javensis in rice fields at a rate of 5,000 adults per hectare, then we should not be spraying any kind of contact or stomach insecticides until 7 to 10 days.
Which type of crop this biological method of pest control is most suitable?
Sir, any crop which is infested with a foreign pest in particular, like in case of papaya, the papaya mealybug is kind of foreign pest. So for these kind of pests, we can effectively use the biological agents. For example, if we are saying like Congress weed is a weed which is growing extensively in road sites. So sir, that is a problem. So sir, we can use the Zygogramma bicolorata, which is a beetle which is brought from the same like native area of that Congress weed. Sir, I'm not remembering the that place, but sir.
These common pests found in potato crop. Can you name some common pests found in potato crop?
Yes, sir. So one is potato tuber moth.
Moth, okay.
Potato tuber moth. And there is sir wire beetle, and sir there is white grub, and
how to control it?
Sir, the moth can be controlled by spraying the contact insect. Spraying of chlorantraniliprole at the rate of 2 to 4 ml per hectare. Sorry, 2 to 4 ml per liter of water. Then and it also infests the tubers in the storage structure. So during the storage like what? During the story to go down stage, we can use various insecticides which are used in the story to go downs. And said for the beetles, so for the white grubs, we can use the neem tree with.
What's the difference between insecticide and pesticide?
Insecticide and pesticide. So insecticide particular is effective against the insects. Say I can use insect growth regulators, which are very specific in their action. So they are in particularly used against the insects. And the pesticides are those sort of chemicals which are used to kill the pests, which includes insects, then birds, rodents, and pathogens as well.
Okay. Sometime back, actually, one DDT. Have you come across DDT? DDT was very frequently used for this agriculture. Actually. Nowadays, this DDT is banned. Banned or not banned? Why it is banned?
So DDT is banned due to its adverse effect on the environment after a book by Rachel Carson, The Silent Spring, where she highlighted the...
Now what is that adverse effect on the environment?
Sir, it's basically used for control of mosquitoes after World War II. Sir, so there are, after the persistent use of DDT for one or two decades, we came to find out that the yield of crops is highly reducing gradually, and the soil health is also depleting very
much. Yield of crop is decreasing?
Sir, some sort of research in foreign journals. And also, sir, it has effect on, it had some teratogenic effects on body. So, sir, that teratogenic effects presence means that triggered the its ban.
Okay. Supposing actually you are working, actually you have been selected in the bank and you are working in the bank as a financial agriculture officer. Okay. So how you are one day suddenly actually you are in the bank. Simultaneously actually some people, they have one person has come to deposit some agricultural loan he has taken. So now he has come for the repayment of the agricultural loan. He has actually some around 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs he has brought, the farmer has brought, that loan I will close and I will repay the entire loan, one farmer. Another farmer actually, you have called him to disperse one crop loan, to sanction and disperse one crop loan. He has also come. And simultaneously that another person has come, or actually that entire money actually I want to repay. Okay, then another person actually from a local from sarpanch or some political person has come that how many this type of loan we have asked this government scheme is there, some 20 persons we have sent you, why you have not granted? So he has come with some delegation. So how this type of situation, how you will be able to handle in the banks?
One by one,
all people they have come simultaneously. So 3 persons they have come to you simultaneously as an agriculture officer because it is of your department. Isn't it? How you will be able to handle this situation?
Sir, first I will call the person who is arrived first. Sir, the person who has arrived first or the sarpanch?
Or person who has come first. So you will be attending him or her first. So first come first service. No prioritization.
Sir, I don't really know about the priority.
Which is the priority for you?
Sir, I think sarpanch, because he has, he must have come with the issues of
a bulk. That is the priority? But how other people will be handled then?
Sir, I can ask them to wait for a few minutes.
Okay. Thank you. All right.
So feedback is that you have to take care of your body language. Look, you are very good. We know that from the beginning. Okay, you have got knowledge and everything. You are a very good aspirant. So all the best for that. But let me show you the mirror that your body language is something which is not really creating kind of good image about you. You get the point. You don't have any smile on your face. we are a little bit depressed. And you know, like kind of.
Why you are depressed? No need.
As if you are not satisfied with yourself, you are not interested to sit in this interview, you are not interested to answer the questions, you are not a pressure. So don't let these things come out.
Yeah.
Okay, so have a control over your emotions. Just come very frankly because you are the king of your life. Okay, things definitely going to happen good with you. So you just need to have a smile on your face. Let others feel that you are happy with them and let others feel they are happy with you. And just listen to in a very communicative, a lot attentive manner. Listen to their questions, nodding your head and answer and look at everyone in the panel. And process your knowledge, banking awareness, current affairs knowledge. Just refresh.
Yes. Refresh. Brush up. You have to brush up.
Yeah.
Okay, this is situational based questions actually. Okay, you may not answer, but they actually, what about delegation? Something actually, one term is the delegation. You have to delegate some other, one person cannot handle all the things simultaneously. That is truth, but actually it happens. It happens in a practical life, it happens. So how to handle this? We have to handle. So handle means it is delegation, repayment, you can have your junior person will be there.
Okay.
You can delegate that work to him and to him or her. Okay. Then other things you can handle. Okay, important, most important thing you have to yourself you have to handle. Other things actually you have to delegate and also that you have to make them understand so that they should not feel otherwise. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.